Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to see how the iSpring Content Library offers you a bunch of cool assets you can add to make your online quizzes much more engaging and realistic. The Content Library is available in QuizMaker as part of the larger iSpring Suite authoring powerhouse. You can still use some of the assets even without a subscription, though, so feel free to give it a test drive. Let's check out how this mini personality quiz was enhanced with the content library. To add extra content to your quiz slides, just go to slide view mode. As you can see, the emotional range of the characters is perfect for something like a personality quiz. To add a character, go to the insert tab and click the characters button. The character library has a truckload of different characters from all walks of life. And to find exactly what you're looking for, you can use these criteria here on the left. As you can see, there are plenty of emotions to choose from. Once your character is on the slide, you can always replace it by right-clicking and going to Change Picture. Let's just pick a different pose for this guy. Also, you can resize the image and even crop it to fit perfectly. As you can see on this first question slide, cropping comes in handy when you want to show the upper half of a character. This blue background was taken from the backgrounds library, but let's go to the second question to see a more realistic background. Just click the backgrounds button, and you'll see a wide selection of different locations. Again, you can narrow down your search on the left, and the blue background can be found in the abstract section. But there's plenty of other realistic locations to choose from. Now, this slide looks pretty cool with the guy in the chair in the office and everything, but I think there's a way to make the question text look even cooler. So let's hop over here to the Objects library. Here you'll find a bunch of stuff that you'd normally see in an office, plus a bunch of different devices. Let's grab this notepad here. We'll put the notepad over to the side, and move this guy here. First, what we need to do is send the notepad to the back so the text will be on top of it. Now we can move the answer choices to the bottom of the notepad, and then squeeze this question text box on top of it. Now that looks cool! You might also want to change this font to something more scripty, but I think you get the idea. Thanks for watching! I'm sure you'll be more than content with all the new content you can add to your online quizzes. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.